Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to another episode of Cairo Local Time. Today's episode is a special edition, and it is marking the 25th of January, both the revolution and the 65th National Police Day as well. In this special edition, we will be taking a look at several items and doing several interviews concerning today's special event. But first, let's take a look at a report where President Abdel Fattah Sisi praised and honored on Tuesday policemen killed in recent years in a celebration marking Police Day, saying that Egypt is fighting a vicious war and the whole world knows that it is fighting alone. As Sisi said that Egypt had been fighting a 40-month war by men who took responsibility to protect the Egyptians, referring to the policemen. He honored a number of police martyrs and families. Nile TV's reporter Linda Abdul Latif gave us this report.
President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi witnessed a celebration marking the National Police Day at the Police Academy, and upon his arrival, the president led a wreath at the memorial of the police martyrs. I would like to wish all the best to all policemen on the occasion of the National Police Day, which symbolizes their sacrifice and perseverance. And I stress that we will always continue our journey to protect Egypt's stability and security. During the ceremony, President Sisi delivered a speech where he expressed his appreciation and hailed the sacrifices made by the policemen in face of security challenges facing the country. He said that the police martyrs who sacrificed their lives for Egypt will never be forgotten, and called for providing the martyrs' families with the utmost care. President Sisi also noted that facing all the domestic, regional, and international challenges are easy to face if all Egyptians remain united. The president also added that Egypt is a state of institutions, expressing respect to all those institutions, be them the army, police, or others. The president also said that Egypt is facing a fierce battle against terrorism and is fighting it courageously. President Sisi also added that the economic development we are seeking can only be achieved in an atmosphere of security and stability, adding that achieving this requires great efforts. And during the ceremony, President Sisi honored the families of a number of police martyrs. As much as I'm hurt for the loss of my son, I'm not sad because my son is a martyr. God has honored him and chose him. And I felt that my son is an honor for the country and has done his job to the fullest. And it was the biggest honor for me to be called the mother of a martyr. So I'm happy that I was able to present something to my country. The Police Day was chosen on the 25th of January to mark the day in 1952 on which Egypt's police fought a heroic battle against the British occupation in Smaliyah City, overlooking the west bank of the Suez Canal. The British occupation, which was present in Egypt from 1882 until 1956, issued warning to the Egyptian forces to evacuate the sea so they can take full control of the canal. But police forces stood their grounds. 50 police personnel were killed and over 80 injured. During the ceremony, President Sisi also thanked a number of policemen for their distinguished performance and dedication. It was great to be honored by the president, and I thank my bosses who have chosen me to be among the honored. All policemen put the heroic battle of the Egyptian policemen against the British occupation into consideration as a motive for achievement of moving forward in fighting terrorism, which is threatening the whole world. Addressing the gathering, Minister of Interior General Magdi Abdel Ghaffar said that the security challenges will only strengthen the will of the policemen, adding that they will exert their utmost efforts to protect the country, and said that modernizing the security apparatus is a top priority.
The National Police Day has always been a great opportunity to show policemen the country's appreciation of their work and sacrifices. Linda Abdel Latif, Nile TV International.
يوم الشهيد ابنك بطل اتبارك. قلبي وحكي.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ولا تحسبن الذين قتلوا في سبيل الله أمواتا بل أحياء عند ربهم يرزقون. الشهيد محمد أنور ده ابني الوحيد ومش خسارة في مصر.
ربيتي أحسن تربية علمتي معنى التضحية ولا حاجة أغلى من الضنا وانتي صبورة مؤمنة قلتي دي حكمة ربنا علشان أكيد مطمنة إنه في مكان دلوقتي أجمل من هنا. ربيتي أحسن تربية علمتي معنى التضحية ولا حاجة أغلى من الضنا وانتي صبورة مؤمنة قلتي دي حكمة ربنا علشان أكيد مطمنة إنه في مكان
اوعى تتصوروا ان سقوط ولاد مصر ما يوجعناش، لا ازاي، بس ولاد مصر دول سقطوا عشان تفضل مصر.
يا امي اوعي تحزني زمانه في الجنه مع الملايكه تطمني واكيد
special episode of Cairo Local Time. We're honored and delighted to have our distinguished guest, Lieutenant General and Dr. Ahmed Ghed. He's the former head of the Police Academy and Assistant Minister of Interior. مساء الخير لحضرتك، كل سنه وحضرتك طيب ومناسبه.
Happy Returns of the Day. Thank you very much.
بالصحه والسلامه.
انطباع حضرتك ايه عن الخطاب بتاع السيسي
address on the occasion of Police Day؟
My
analysis to the content of the president's address is that he was paying tribute and appreciation and all the respect to the police men who contributed with the military in bringing back peace and stability to Egypt. The president expressed appreciation for all the sacrifices made by policemen and the martyrs and the people injured. And also President Sisi met with a huge number of the families and the relatives and the wives and mothers of the martyrs. This carries a very important message to the whole world that Egypt never forgets its sons, and the Ministry of Interiors never forgets its martyrs and those who were injured. This is the first message. The second message was to the whole world that Egypt is strong, Egypt is stable, that Egypt is determined to go into the track of development regardless of the challenges and regardless of the conspirators, those who conspire against Egypt. And Egypt is determined to uproot terrorism. And we actually made unprecedented successes, because terrorism during the security unrest in 2011 was enormous and was centralized in northern Sinai. But due to the great security measures, many successes took place. The president confirmed that Egypt is determined to fight terrorism. A third message to the society. The president talked about the importance of family cohesion and the importance of not taking hasty decisions as far as divorce is concerned, because this will have consequences. The president instructed the concerned authorities in the country to search for a legal mechanism to limit this family fragmentation. And the president also addressed young people, told them that Egypt is a young country, 60% of its population are young people in the work group, in the working age, and that Egypt is capable of doing a lot. So there were many messages. As for honoring the families of the martyrs, of course, this is a great moral support. but is there any kind of other support by the presidency or the police? Of course, top honor is to have the president honoring the families of the martyrs. The president himself said it. He said that this is a very difficult occasion for him because we're all aware of the difficult situation those families are going through. When a young wife with two kids dreaming with her husband how they will bring up the children in a certain way, and as a result of terrorism, this young wife's life turns into a disaster. Egypt never forgets its sons. It is true that this moral support and honor is good for the psychology of the families, but all the services will support those families until the end. And the Ministry of Interiors has a special sector for providing care to the families of the martyrs and the injured. So there are many people serving those families in different walks of life. This honor is endless. Yesterday translated the attention given by the president to honoring the families of the martyrs. Is there a special focus on the children of the martyrs from the police to be supported in their education, etc.? Yes, I'm telling you, in all walks of life, in different aspects, the widows, if they have any requirements, if they want to perform pilgrimage or umrah or appointment in anything to be hired anywhere, of course, we follow the rules, but they will get the priority. Their applications will be treated with the priority. As for the children, certainly the Ministry of Education is doing a great work as far as the fees are concerned and the transportation, the railways as well, the higher education ministry when they join university. So all states, ministries provide services, and the Ministry of Interiors coordinates amongst all these ministries and start the implementation of the services. The president talked about the call he had with the American President Donald Trump, and that Egypt is fighting terrorism almost alone. What do you think about this phone call, and would the states play an effective role with Egypt in fighting terrorism? Indeed, the president said that we've been fighting terrorism since 2011 very fiercely alone. The president said this in international and regional forum repeatedly. This is why I'm addressing the whole world. I'm sending a message to all concerned bodies that the international community should be aware of this, that terrorism has no country. As we can see, terrorism hits any country in the world now. And so I know that there is conflict in interests, and there are some countries have interest in having terrorism continuing in other countries to achieve some political and economic gains. But I'm saying that now time has come under the umbrella of the United Nations to take the president's speech seriously. An international conference for fighting terrorism must be organized, and through this conference a global agreement should emerge for fighting terrorism and should be submitted to the 193 countries members in the UN to be reviewed and filtered and to agree on a set of articles that the whole international community would agree on, and to be a global pact for fighting terrorism. So if this is not impossible, it is really difficult because of the conflict of interest, but it has become a necessity to fight terrorism. And those who would object from now, I'm telling them, if terrorism is away from you now, it will be very close to you or inside your home very soon. Terrorism is not only in Egypt, it's in Syria and in Iraq. There was terrorism in France, in the States, in Turkey, in Japan, in Spain, so in Belgium, so in many countries, terrorism hit. So why is it that the West is concentrating with Syria and Iraq only, not with the other countries like Libya and Egypt? I'm telling you, it depends on the interests controlling and governing the policy of each state. I'm asking for having an international vision away from any political interests, away from any economic interests, to have a humanitarian vision. And if we can do so, one day we will have hope that we can have an international agreement for fighting terrorism. In continuation to your previous question, and you said whether the states, the United States, will play an effective role in fighting, in helping Egypt or not. If this agreement is concluded, the United States will be one of the strongest countries fighting terrorism because it's a superpower and it has an impact on the United Nations and a permanent member in the Security Council. And can support this international conference with full transparency and neutrality without any personal interests. The president also said that we are going through a war, like the war of 1967 and 1973, but in a different way. How can we compare the war against terror to the 1973 war? Yes, we are in a real war. The 1973 war and the war of attrition before it was with a clear enemy. But now the war is even more difficult because some terrorists are disguised amongst the Egyptian people and they are hiding in very difficult, geographically difficult locations. This is why the war this time is really difficult. But despite of this, a great percentage of terrorism in Egypt has been defeated. But the president is saying that the war now is similar to the war of 73 and 67 because the security unrest that happened after the 28th of January 2011, the borders that were infiltrated by foreign fighters and so on, the president knows quite well the burden of terrorism the country incurs. This is why he's describing it as a real war. And all the people who were waiting to seize the opportunity, they wanted to destroy the Egyptian state. They allowed the entry of weapon and terrorists. But Egypt was not defeated and stood back on its feet, and now we have a strong country with security forces and the military fighting terrorism in a very fierce battle, and we made huge successes. And we made a huge percentage, which is more than 70% in fighting terrorism, and we got rid of many of terrorist leaders, the leaders of terrorism. I do not want to talk about the incidents happening here and there every now and then. It's a real war, and that the end victory will be for the noble, honorable men of Egypt. How can we know the number of terrorists in Sinai in general? You were just saying that they hide amongst civilians, they are disguising. So how can we know the number of terrorist spots? We have full specifications, and we know these spots, and with the help of intelligence we discovered them, and we do some preemptive attacks. And if you can notice, that in some of the newspapers we find news about detaining a number of or arresting a number of terrorists before carrying out a terrorist attack. It is true that some of them are hiding, but through the help of the security and the intelligence, we can arrest them. So we are arresting people before they commit terrorist attacks, and but they might succeed in doing some incidents which would lead to some martyrs from the policemen and the police personnel and soldiers. But the number of terrorist attacks is diminishing, and I'm affirming to you that terrorism will come to an end in Egypt. And by the way, this is what God Almighty said, that Egypt is protected until doomsday. This is what God Almighty said, and that Egypt has the best soldiers in the world. No one can defeat the police in Egypt, the Egyptians, the Egyptian army, and the Egyptian police and the army is taken very seriously by all other countries, because we're a strong army and no one can defeat it. This is a message to anyone, any party conspiring, wanting to harm our country. I'm telling them that Egypt will not be defeated. On this occasion, the assassinations taking place for policemen and for police personnel in general, does it have an impact on policemen while performing their duties? I cannot say that there is an impact. You know that when this happens, this would leave families in a very disastrous situation. But this is the value we teach our students, that they are entrusted with achieving the security of this country and of the Egyptian citizens. So this is the belief they are taught when they are in the police academy. And as for the colleagues who will be affected because of their friends' killing or assassination, we have in the police academy educational materials and films that raise their morals and their religious and their professional beliefs. We also provide them training to believe and to be sure that they are entrusted with a great task, and that they will be ready, they will not be afraid. And I want to tell you that many policemen submit requests to go and serve in Northern Sinai. So why are they doing this? Why would they like to leave their wife and their family? Because of the belief they have deep inside. For them, the country is something really great, and they want to protect their country and their colleagues. Are there trainings to police officers on technical aspects regarding fighting terrorism, because there are many changes that has happened? Of course, since 2011 up till now, many changes took place. And we know that there was security chaos, and also the situation in fighting terrorism has expanded. And of course, now there is usage of modern weapons and new tools. And as the Ministry of Interiors is developing itself in this, terrorists and criminals are also developing the weapons they use and the trainings they get. This is why the policemen and the Ministry of Interiors are aware of the full picture and So our training now is higher, our education is higher, our equipments are higher to be more efficient and more capable of fighting terrorism. I cannot allow myself as security forces and as military to be below than the level of terrorism. This is why we are so keen as a country to have very sophisticated training and very high equipment to have the upper hand to confront terrorism. But I want to tell you that this requires a huge cost. Achieving security and fighting terrorism is very costly because you are facing a very bloody terrorism that has sophisticated weapons. This is why we are saying that achieving and realizing security is so costly. We want to train, we want to educate, we want to raise awareness, we want weapons and equipment and tanks, and this costs billions, not millions. And we really hope that the state's budget, when it is okay, to be capable of getting financial resources to support the security apparatus. And when it is supported, the number of martyrs will not be the same. We have reached approximately 900 martyrs and 16,000 injured in the past 5 years. So when the president says that we are in a real war, this is what is translated by those numbers. Are the numbers of the war. 25th of January is the police day for a certain reason. How did this day form the history of police? In 1952, 25th of January was allocated to be police day, not because police refused to hand over weapons, but because Police Day is a symbol to patriotism. What do I mean? The police then fought the British in the Ismailiyah battle. 800 policemen were fighting 7,000 British soldiers. They were facing tanks and armored vehicles. The British troops wanted the police to go to Cairo and to leave the canal area so that they can arrest the fidais or the people responsible for resistance. But no, the police refused to leave the canal area. So the British troops started this fight because police refused to go to Cairo. And so the battle continued for 6 hours, in which 50 policemen were killed and many were injured, and the battle ended just because of the ammunition. The ammunition finished, and that was a symbolic battle. The police fighting the British troops. And the second symbol is that that was the day of unity between the people and the police. There were approximately 91,000 civil workers working in the camps of the British troops. All of them refused to work, and the railway workers refused to work. And as a result of this, the British camps stopped. And during the war, the citizens helped the police and tried to provide them with food and ammunition. That was also a unity between the police and the people. And I want here to express my gratitude to the young people in Cairo who went to Ismailia to support the police in fighting the British. So that was the day of unity between the police and the people. So this is the meaning of the Police Day. And there is another meaning for Police Day. It is a symbol of national unity because the 800 policemen had amongst them Muslims and Christians. There were amongst them a group of Christians, Officer Abdel Messiah Morqus, who is still alive up till now. And when they pledged to fight the occupying troops when they joined hands to read Al-Fatha from the Quran. He told them, wait, I together with my Christian friends would recite Al-Fatha with you, verses from the Quran. So it's a unity between Muslims and Christians. So Police Day represents national unity. I am sending a message to those who conspire. Never play on sectarian divisions, because Muslims and Christians have been united in Ismailia, in Sinai, in different wars of Egypt, and they will never be separated. Yes, so we pray that Egypt will always enjoy national unity. Sorry, we're running out of time. Thank you and many happy returns of the day. I'm sending a message to all Egyptian people, to the president and to the government and to all Egyptians and police. Many happy returns of the day. Thank you.
This brings us to the end of this segment. We were joined by Lieutenant General Dr. Ahmed Ghed, the former head of the Police Academy and the assistant, former assistant foreign, rather interior minister. Let's take a look now at a report on the history of policemen and what they did in sacrifice for this nation.
Killed and more wounded when they refused British demands to hand over weapons and evacuate Ismailia police station on the 25th of January 1952. The British Army surrounded the police station, then brought tanks in and took over the station. The event sparked anti-British riots throughout Egypt and paved the way for the revolution 6 months later. Police Day was long celebrated by marches and demonstrations, culminating with a speedboat parade on the Nile. As the regime came to rely increasingly on police repression to maintain power, it year by year increased the pageantry of the events. Finally, in 2009, Police Day was raised to be a national holiday, during which banks and government offices would be closed. Anthropologists, sociologists, and culturally minded political scientists have often noted to important role ritual plays in establishing and maintaining nation states. Most states have ritual calendars similar to and often running parallel with the sacred calendars of local religious institutions. Egypt has Shem Nessim, Sinai Liberation Day, Labor Day, Revolutionary Day, and the Armed Forces Day. Holidays like these help states make the nations real by converting the imagined communities of Egypt into collective action. They do this in at least two ways, through shared symbolic content and through shared activity. On the one hand, they trot out powerful symbols of national identity like flags and anthems and tie them to the apparatus of the state. But even those who ignore such symbolism participate in the collective ritual by virtue of having the day off. Your participation in the nation becomes real through the disruption of your everyday practices. The state has always sought to appropriate the moral authority of these patriotic martyrs, casting the contemporary fear Egyptian state as the result of their sacrifice.